I just want to give you a shout out to Sari. You are the best.
Crafter is a Twitter influencer with 15,000 followers who mostly posts unfunny memes. He's also exposed multiple creators, such as Roblox Osaka and Clown Chow. Crafter is very respected in the Roblox community, despite not even being in the community itself, and while he's done some bad things, some of which everyone just forgot about completely for some reason. Also, please like and subscribe before the video starts. Thank you. Back in November of 2023, Crafter posted a tweet saying the YouTuber Rurders sent him a £2,000 fine. Crafter also added a GoFundMe in the replies so he could pay this fine. A lot of people believed this and were reposting his tweet so more people found out and could donate, but many people didn't believe this, and when he got called out by larger creators, he ran off and deactivated for a week and came back saying someone else was running the account, which basically proves he was defaming Rurders and trying to scam the Roblox Twitter kids. The GoFundMe is still up, and luckily, no one got a chance to donate. However, if he wasn't called out, people would have donated thinking this was real. Also, if no one donated, then how did he pay this alleged fine? I asked ChatGPT, and even AI says Crafter was lying. Crafter said he was falsely sued by Rurders, and the defamation Crafter was spreading was actually real, which would mean either the fine wasn't false, or it's fake, as you can't fine someone for something they didn't do. I'm gonna let the AI explain.
Yes, it is highly likely that the person is lying and trying to scam you. Here are some key points to consider. Authority to fine. As mentioned earlier, only specific governmental or judicial authorities can issue fines for illegal infractions, such as defamation. A random person does not have the legal authority to impose a fine. Defamation cases typically involve civil litigation. If someone is sued for defamation and loses the case, they might be ordered by a court to pay damages, but this would come from a court ruling, not a fine imposed by an individual. Proof provided. The image you provided shows an envelope marked urgent with a crown symbol, suggesting it might be from a governmental body. However, this is not proof of a fine for defamation. Official fines or court judgments would come with detailed documentation, including the name of the issuing authority, a case number, and specifics about the ruling. GoFundMe and scams. Setting up a GoFundMe for donations to pay off a supposed fine, especially when the fine is not legitimate, is a common tactic used in scams. It preys on people's goodwill and generosity. Given these points, it is highly probable that the person is attempting to deceive you and others to gain money fraudulently. If you are uncertain, you could verify the legitimacy by asking for detailed official documentation of the fine or court judgment, contacting the supposed issuing authority directly using official channels to confirm the claim. It's important to be cautious and not contribute to the GoFundMe without verifying the legitimacy of the claim.
Even months later, Crafter claims that he wasn't lying and Rodas did actually fine him, and even more recently I called Crafter a scammer and he told me he'd debunked the allegations in a Google Doc. So I searched through the whole thing and there was no mention of Rodas, a GoFundMe, or even scamming at all in the doc. Also, yes, Rodas is a bad person, however defaming him and using his bad reputation to scam kids makes you no better than him. My beef with Crafter started back in January when he blocked me for being friends with Seb Motions, which, funnily enough, is something he is now guilty of. He also deleted his message telling me he blocked me for being friends with Seb sometime within the past few months. Then in April, Crafter replied to one of my tweets saying I dislike him by accusing me of being transphobic towards him. Correct me if I'm wrong here, but pretty sure Crafter is cisgender, and I happen to be non-binary, which falls under the trans umbrella, meaning that if I called Crafter quote-unquote transphobic slurs, it wouldn't be transphobic. Also, that literally just never happened anyway. Crafter knew I wasn't cis as he mentioned seeing the trans flag in my name when I spoke to him next, so that's funny. The next encounter was in May when I made a bait tweet and Crafter replied, talking about a group chat from a few days earlier, to debunk his points about my friend posting weird stuff. I don't control what Churu does. If you don't like it, just block him, and I have told him to stop many times, and eventually I just cut him off. So that point is kinda irrelevant now. And to debunk the first two screenshots, they were obviously jokes. I did stop being edgy recently, so it's not like I'll be making those jokes again. Also, Crafter makes the exact same jokes too. He's made multiple jokes about Dream being a pedophile, even after Dream debunked everything, and his excuse was that he's just joking and it's just dark humor. He says he wasn't comfortable with my jokes, which if so, my bad, but like it wasn't obvious. But if you want to talk about being uncomfortable with people's jokes in that group chat, then let's talk about how Crafter and his friend were mocking my Crafter asked me why I deactivated. I told him I didn't want to say it, but it was serious. Crafter then made a joke about me saying serious and my name is Serious Cat, and then his friend was saying I deserved whatever happened. Eventually, I told them why I deactivated and neither apologized, and the only thing Crafter said was that who cares because his friend has no career to lose. Like, I feel like that isn't really an appropriate response. He's basically defending his friend. Then when I mentioned this on Twitter, he just said I was lying multiple times instead of actually apologizing. This will be a shorter segment because this is just funny. So, Crafter made a Google Doc exposing a Roblox YouTuber called Ringheads, and I replied with some of the most obvious rage bait ever, and Crafter still seemed to fall for it. Crafter still uses me quote-unquote defending Ringheads as proof I'm a bad person, so I think he might be stupid. He also made a group chat to argue with me over this, like how could he not tell I was joking? Crafter has a massive ego and is honestly really stupid, so when he made his Twitter thread on Roblox Osaka, he made it on his alternate account because he didn't want clout from this. Then when the thread blew up, he apparently immediately applied for a Guinness World Record and turned his alt account into an exposing account where he would help smaller creators expose people, because for some reason he thinks all of his exposing tweets are gonna get millions of views because his first one did, which by the way, this account flopped and he abandoned it. He also brags about owning the Explorer Elizabeth account and has it connected to his Discord when he literally doesn't own it. Also, back to that group chat from earlier, Crafter was bragging about how much he earned from his Twitter almost immediately after being added, and knowing Crafter, he's probably lying about that too to make himself look better. Basically, Crafter is overrated. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, follow me on Twitter, and for now, goodbye. Yeah.